that lesson should be a one-to-one challenge. So you take such a lesson. So practice it with calmness exercise. For example, you sit just 20 minutes in a calm posture without doing studying or thinking. Don't think that you are calm. You must be too calm that you are not thinking about the calmness also. So you sit there and make yourself relax, then go through that. And then this one exercise number one. Number two, you take the vital points. You take the vital points. For example, I told about computational evolutionary biology. I have given a name. But what is biology? What is evolution? What is computation? We don't know. Just we spell the words. So you select 10 or 15 words where you are not understanding the concepts. It may be whimsical or it may be quixotic for you to accept my exposition now. But I think that it is really true, and you will also know the same if you practice it. Just you think about the word without thinking about anything, without any inputs from your book. Do it for 10 days. You will see some wonders. Certainly somebody should see some wonder, positive wonders. So you take the key words. You take the words which are observing to be challenges, not as words, but as concepts. If you say nanobiology, that word is not a problem. Somebody, some boy told you, how was the question paper? Somebody asked somebody else. He told the question paper was okay, answers were problem. Question was not hard. Like that, no word is problemsome for us. But that answer may be problemsome. So the second exercise, first exercise is, before studying the challenging lesson, you take a rest, complete calmness for 15 or 20 minutes, then read them. Don't try it. There are three things: to read, to study and learn. To read, to study and learn. Just going through the thing is to read. First you have to read. Then after pacifying your emotions and volcanic burst, I already told neural warming, after everything happens, then with a little bit acquaintance of verses and phrases, you go through that. That is studying. Then after that exercise is over, third time it is learning. You practice these three things with a gap in between as well as before and after. This is over, first exercise. Second exercise, it is very wonderful. This is you are learning, studying and reading at least. After everything is learnt, after everything is learnt. See, if you have studied and learnt everything, it is enough if you read it at the time of examinations. If you are reading daily, then you have to study and learn at the time of examinations. If you study and learn and master the things at the time of learning, there are two times. There are two timings. One is the timing where you have to produce it. The second time is where you have to reproduce it. When the teacher is teaching you, whenever you are going through the same syllabus at your house for your homework or for reading or for anything else, whenever there is a teacher and student subjectivity in a subject, that is known as producing moment. Whenever the class, either a narration or interview or examinations, you are asked something, that is reproducing moment. At the time of producing it inside or installation, if it is learnt, you need not learn it at the time of examination. You throw the books away. At the time of examination, if you read, it will come. Or you have to at least study. No need to learn it again. But it is not so. The second exercise is very simple. You take few words, 20 or 25 words. They must not be mere words. They must be connective concepts. For example, if you say Bohr's atomic model, then that is not only a word which is connected with model or atom. It connects with a system of presentation with a diagram and functional structure. So take such a word which has intensive coverage. Don't take small words. If I want to take you some good words or some risky words, you should not take some philosophical words which have no extensive or intensive ruling. Take some words which have intensive dimensional coverage. Like it may be heading of an experiment. It may be heading of a synthesis or hypothesis. It may be the heading of a law. So without looking the book, I swear in this stage, I believe that it is the stage or the podium or the platform, everything to be the personification of wisdom. I will wish that you will also experience the same. Without looking the book, you just think about the concepts without thinking anything. Law of conservation of energy, what is momentum? What is momentum? What you do and be. So if you are going for auto-suggestion or self-suggestion, you may get something good or something wrong, something deviating or something confusing and something totally stagnant and still. But still don't forget that. In the first exercise, you will not get that. Then every house will have two instincts. If everybody in the first exercise, if they can get the cognitive ability, every house will have two instincts and three Osama bin Ladens if the thinking is more. So it should be very processive. If you don't process, there are two possibilities. You will be overproductive or overaggressive. I have given examples for both the things. So take the process. So if you think about these things, I believe after 10 or 12 such exercises of 20 or 15 minutes each, don't sit for hours together and don't throw it away. Sit for 2 or 3 minutes, make it 5 or 10. Gradually you develop the exercises, introspective exercises where you are trying from a blank with your word. Without any input, you are trying from a blank. You will get two benefits. One, if you are so benefited or if you are so blessed, you will get whatever you are there having in your notebook or no, having in your syllabus. But that thing is far remote. But I am assuring this benefit, second benefit, whenever after doing these exercises, if you look the book, that will go as if you have cut cheese inside your mouth without any strain or struggle. And whenever you study that, even though you would not have thought the same thing, you would have traveled only in blankness, you may not be knowing the same thing, but whenever you feel some sort of affinity and brotherhood in the stuff as if you have read it before. The first benefit is, you will get the same law of conservation of energy without seeing the book. That is divine. Just for a manual exercise and for your human visible benefit, the second benefit is very simple. You can feel as if you have learned this several times, and that will be a cheese cutting exercise, and that will be very smoothly entering inside your caliber, making you more effective. So with these two exercises, we can start the calmness exercise, and in later sessions, we can discuss about other things. Narayan, Narayan.